This is a 2019 question paper for 6 marks. I will read out the question quickly. The following balances are appearing in the books of Weldon Limited. 6% redeemable preference share capital 5 lakhs, 100 each, less calls in arrears of 10,000 rupees, 4,90,000, general reserve, security premium, development rebate reserve. Redeemable preference shares are redeemed at a premium of 10%. Calls in arrears of 500 shares were duly collected and adjusted. Security premium and general reserve was fully utilized, and for the required amount of equity shares, 10 each at a premium of 10% was issued and collected and redemption process carried out. Write journal entries to the above fact. Guys, I hope all of you have written this question in your book. The following balances appearing in the books of Weldon Limited, 6% redeemable preference share capital, 5 lakhs, 100 rupees each, less calls in arrears, 20 per share, 10,000 rupees, and we have received only 4,90,000. Another 10,000 rupees is still in calls in arrears. And what is given in the adjustment is, calls in arrears is made and duly received. So, first what we need to do is, we have to pass the journal entry. See, journal entries, first journal entry is receiving, okay, calls in arrears money. Once if you receive calls in arrears money, bank account debit to calls in arrears account 10,000 rupees, assume that we have received. So what is the narration you write is a calls in arrears money received. So that means we have 10,000 rupees of money which we have received through by calls in arrears. Next, if you read general reserve, we have 3 lakhs, security premium we have 40,000, development rebate reserve as 2 lakh rupees. As we know that we never ever use the development rebate reserve for the payment capital portion of the preference share capital. But we can utilize general reserve and only general reserve, because now we need to redeem 5 lakh rupees of share capital, preference share capital, but the available general reserve with us is only 3 lakh rupees. Now let us have this chart, okay, so that this chart will help us. Say first we need to pay for capital portion, we have to pay 5 lakh rupees. For this we have two options. Either we can go for out of profit, or else we can go for fresh issue. Am I right? Now, out of profits, we have general reserve of 3 lakh rupees. Now, when you want to pay 5 lakh rupees as in for the capital portion of the preference share capital, available our divisible profit in the form of general reserve is only 3 lakhs. Then we need to arrange another 2 lakh rupees for the capital portion of the preference. Now we can go for fresh issue of equity share capital. Now 3 lakh rupees and 2 lakh rupees, 5 lakh rupees we can pay for what? Preference share capital. Now whatever the amount which we have taken out of profits, that has to be transferred to where? Capital redemption reserve. Am I right, sirs? So how much we are transferring to capital redemption reserve? 3 lakh rupees we are transferring. Now fresh issue, what is given in the question? If you read the question, you will understand clearly. Redeemable preference shares are redeemed at a premium of 10%. Now this is a capital portion. What about the premium portion? Say that is redemption premium. Say redemption premium. We are paying 10%. 10% on 5 lakh rupees is 50,000 rupees we have to arrange for redemption premium. For the capital portion, we have arranged 3 lakh rupees as a general reserve for the payment of capital portion of the share capital. And remaining 2 lakh rupees, we are going for fresh issue. Now, we have to arrange for redemption premium also. But here, in the question, we can pay off this redemption reserve out of security premium. Out of security premium. Security premium, we will have a old balance and a new balance. See, already in the question it is given, 40,000 rupees is available. 40,000 rupees security premium is available. Once, if the security premium old balance 40,000 is available, how much is required for us to arrange for redemption premium is only 10,000 rupees. Let us see how we can arrange. If you read the calls in arrears, 500 shares is collected, received. Security premium and general reserve fully utilized for the required amount. And equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of 10% was issued and collected. See, if 2 lakh rupees is the money which we require for fresh issue and each share value is how much? 10 rupees. How many shares we are issuing? 20,000 shares we are issuing. For capital portion 10, we get 2 lakh rupees. For premium portion, if you multiply with 1 rupee, how do you got this? 10 rupees, 10% premium means you get 1 rupee as a premium. Now, on this 20,000 into 1, 20,000 shares into 1 rupee of premium, you will get 20,000 rupees of new security premium. Now, the security premium becomes 40,000 plus 20,000, 60,000. So, it becomes how much? 60,000. How much is required for us is only 50,000 and the balance 10,000 we can keep it with us. So, that means we have arranged for payment of capital as well as redemption premium. Understood, guys? Okay, fine. Now, what is the journal entries which we need to pass? First, for call scenarios, we made an entry. The second entry is we'll go for fresh issue of shares. So, for fresh issue of shares, bank account debit. See, how much cash we are receiving through by fresh issue is 2 lakh rupees plus 20,000 rupees of premium. 2,20,000 rupees of capital money we are receiving through by share application account. 2,20,000 rupees. After this, receiving the share application money, we need to transfer share application to share capital. So, share application account debit 2,20,000. In this 2,20,000, share capital portion is 2 lakh rupees. See, share capital portion is 2 lakh rupees. And premium portion is how much? 20,000 to security premium. 20,000. Now, fresh issue entry is over. Next, we have to arrange for payment of capital portion of preferential capital. How did you arrange it? Through general reserve of 3 lakh rupees. So therefore, general reserve account debit 3 lakh rupees. Where we need to transfer to CRR account. Capital redemption reserve account. 3 lakh rupees. Okay guys, so we arranged for capital portion. Now we have to arrange for redemption portion. So that is redemption premium portion. So redemption premium, how we arrange? Both securities only, security premium only. So therefore, security premium account debit 50,000 to redemption premium account 50,000. So this also we have arranged. What is the next entry we need to pass is showing the preference share capital due to the preference share holders. Now, redeemable preference share capital account debit 5 lakh rupees. Premium on premium on redeemable preference share capital. Premium on redemption debit 50,000 to redeemable preference share preference share holders account is 5,50,000. So we are showing it as due. So think that, see, in the question is incomplete. Say we through by share capital we have raised 2 lakh plus 22 lakh 20 cash is there with us, and another 10,000 rupees calls in arrears money we have received, 2 lakh 30,000 we have. But in order to pay off the preference shareholders 5 lakh 50, we need some more money. So we assume that some investment we have sold, or else you can pay off this last entry as shown, redeemable preference share holders account debit 5,50,000 to bank account 5,50,000. Okay guys, so this is the last journal entry, 7th journal entry we can pass. If you pass these 7 journal entries, you will get 6 marks. So same journal entries for all the problems we have to pass, and there is no change in the order or change in the accounts also, procedure also. Once if you go back to my video, journal entries video, you can see the same entries which are passed. So please take this question, take this answer and practice it.